Want to spice up your live stream with some graphics? We're going to show you exactly how to make your own. Graphic overlays on a live stream can create instant credibility. You look automatically more professional and like you actually know what you're talking about. Yay! Done right, graphics can hold attention longer because they're gonna help you emphasize a point that you're making, and they're going to keep that visual interest by moving things along. But graphics programs can be a little intimidating, so we're gonna show you how to create beautiful custom graphics inside of Canva to make it easier, how to export them properly, don't make a mistake here, and how to import them into your streaming software. In this video, I'm gonna use Restream for that because it's a very simple and easy way to go live so that you can get started streaming very quickly so you have no excuses. No excuses. But all of the same principles apply, so you can use the same graphics in any streaming software you choose. Okay, I gotta admit something. I don't do graphics because the team doesn't allow me to do graphics because I'm so wretched at them. So I brought in one of our team members, Greg Corhan, who is trained as a graphic designer and who does some of the video assets in our videos. And he's gonna walk you through how to do this so you do it right and you don't follow my bad advice.
Okay, so let's dive right into Canva. From the Canva homepage, we're going to create a new design. So we want to go up to the top right corner where it says create a design and click on that. And then click on custom size. And we're going to try for 1920 by 1080 pixels. You'll notice that it comes up with some suggested sizes, some templates for presentation, video, talking presentation. You could select one of those if you want to. Now we're gonna do a very simple design called a lower third. It's called a lower third because back in the days of television broadcast, they would put the name and the title of the interviewee in the lower third of the screen so it didn't interfere with the person's face. It didn't really take up the entire lower third, but it just became known for the area in which the title was placed. We're gonna start by grabbing a box. We need a box. So you're gonna go over to the left-hand side and click on Elements. We're going to grab or gradient. There we go, gradient. It's gonna come right up. There's lots of different ones that you can choose. I'm just gonna choose this pink. Now we're gonna shape it by just making it tall and skinny, right about there-ish, and then we're gonna make it the full width of the screen. There we go. The next thing we're gonna need to do is add some text. And by that, we're gonna click on the T for text. We're just gonna add a heading, so we can click on add a heading, and a heading will show up on the screen. We're gonna type in whatever our title is for our lower third. Move to the edge and just kind of drag it into position. In the top, you could see the text is centered. You could choose how to, the font size and everything else. Say Open Sans for the font. I'm gonna choose a much larger size, 48 point. I'm gonna change the color. You can change it to white. I'd like to make it bold. I'd also like to make it all uppercase. For the under alignment, I'm gonna set it to left align. Then I'm just gonna simply move the edge in a little bit. Click on name again. And way up in the right, there's a little duplicate button. I'm gonna click on duplicate, drag it along, you'll feel it go click right into alignment. Text to something else, uniquely, yo. And that's pretty good, except it's a little light. I can't really see it as well. So I'm gonna take my mouse and click on the bar that I put in the background. Way up at the top, you can see effects and filter and adjust. You can change, but we're not gonna deal with all that right now. All I'm gonna do is go up to flip, and I'm gonna say flip horizontal, and that's gonna put the dark side of the gradation over on the left, right where the text is. Now it's much more readable for my lower third. Sometimes lower thirds have a logo, and so I'm gonna go find an icon, I'm gonna go back to Elements, I'm gonna click on Elements, and I'm gonna get all sorts of unicorns that I can use. I'm gonna choose this guy right here. Now it says Pro. When you hover over it, it says Pro. You need to have a pro account in Canva anyway. It's not that expensive, but you're gonna need to have a pro account to download the proper type of file. Way too big. So I'm just gonna have it kind of break the line a little bit like this. If you hold down the shift while you use the arrow keys, it'll jump in blocks of 10 pixels so you can kind of adjust it faster. And let's say that's where we want. Now this is not a high-end design. I just wanted to show you some of the possibilities. And then all you need to do is go up to the very top where the little download icon is, and then click on icon, and they're gonna give you PDF as the default. But what you wanna do is go up to PNG, size is 1, so it's the same size. We don't want it half size or double size. We want the size that we spec'd it. And this is the most important. You need to click transparent background. And for that, that's why you need the pro account. So then we're just going to click download. And then once it's downloaded, you're ready to upload it into your streaming software.
If you're learning something today, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, turn on the bell notification so you don't miss any new videos. Oh my gosh, that's so cute. Thank you, Greg. All right, let's get this bad boy into Restream Studio. This is the dashboard for Restream. In order to load in your graphics, you're going to click Enter Live Studio. And here we are. So on the right side of your screen, you're going to see 3 tabs: chat, captions, and graphics. Click on the graphics section. And in this tab, you're going to be able to choose your brand setting. So your colors, things like that. So go through all of those choices. And then it's really super simple. You're going to load in your different files, the logo. You can load in video clips, a background image. Right now, we're going to load in that awesome overlay graphic Greg created just by clicking this little plus sign. Choose the file, open, and then it's gonna pop up right here in your graphics section, and all you have to do is click the word show. And voila, we've got my Uniquely You Lower Third. See how super simple that was? That's what I love about Restream Live Studio, is how easy it is to go live, get some graphics in there, and not have any excuses. I mean, you can load in all kinds of different graphics like this one. Restream is taking care of both you and us by sponsoring this episode. You can get your $10 credit at livestreamingpros.com/restream and check out for yourself how simple it is to go live right now. No excuses. If all this seems overwhelming, or you're just like me and you don't want to beat your head against the wall trying to create graphics that put your brand's best foot forward, then don't worry, we've got you covered. The magical Mr. Paul Dixon has created a bunch of overlay graphics just for you. All you have to do is choose, download, load into Restream or your streaming software of choice, and you're good to go. If you want to learn more about graphics and overlays for your live streams, go ahead and check this playlist out to dive deeper. And if you get stuck along the way, just join one of our live Q&As and we'll get your questions answered. I'll see you in the next video.